We got J Hawk Gaming. Let's get it.
She told me put my heart in the bag, and nobody gets hurt. Now I'm running from your love. I'm not fast, so I'm making it worse. Now I'm digging up a grave for my past. I'm a whole different person.
Yo, what's up, YouTube? It's your boy J Hawk here, and welcome to another Mexico City franchise video. Today we're taking on the Tigers and White Sox. Starting off the action here, game one of this four-game series in Detroit, and Bo Meyers serves up a slider right in the middle of the zone for Cameron Maybin to hit a two-run home run, so they got a 2-0 lead. Morello's got a runner at third, and he drives him in with a base hit through the hole right there, so we got ourselves a 2-1 ball game now, trying to come back real quick. And in the bottom of the eighth, Aristi just serves one up. Johnson Scope makes us pay for that. The Tigers, out of all these teams, are giving us problems. 4-1, ninth inning, Buck Farmer looking for the save. Fly ball out to the center fielder, and he makes the catch. Detroit takes game one, 4-1. Offensively, as you see right here with the box score, just couldn't get nothing going. Pitching-wise, Mayer didn't pitch bad. It was just we couldn't get run support, so... Tough way to lose the first game in the series, but we got three more games to go. So let's do this, man. Let's do it. Game two of this four-game series here in Detroit. And we got Newton in the first inning. He hit second in this game. Deep drive to left field. It might get over his head, and it does get over his head. Look at Newton. He's been showing power. 11 on the year for him gives us an early 1-0 lead. Here's Crook up at the plate. And he hits a ground ball. Grounds out, but gets the runner home. Top four. And look at my boy Nick Banks. Good God. No doubt to right field. 4-0 lead. The captain showing his power again. Top seven. 3-0 count. Hits a base hit in the right field. We're going to send the runner from second. The throw to the plate. Not in time. He is safe. So top seven, and he's picked off a second, trying to be aggressive right there. Not good sign right there. It's 5-1 in the seventh inning, and it gets even worse as Crook gets hurt. Hopefully it's not a bad injury. If so, we're in trouble. Oh my God. Urquidy gives up a long home run. Jonathan Scope is putting damage on us. Look at that. 26 on the year for him. He's trying to keep the Tigers in this game. Kristen Stewart. Deep drive right center field. And it's going to be off the wall in center field. They're going to definitely send the runner from second. And he's easily going to score. So still in the seventh inning. Stroke. Fly ball to center field. So it's going to drive in the runner from third, isn't it? Oh, he's kind of slow. A good throw would have got him, but it's 5-4. Ninth inning. Oh, my God. Banks, do it again, sir. That might be his first multi-home run game since opening day. Either way it goes, another home run for Banks gives us a two-run lead. Booker getting out of base loaded jam, hopefully. Fly ball to the center fielder, Zambrano. And he will make the catch. So that way to bounce back. Good way to bounce back and take game two of this series. Offensively, Nick Banks was the story, a multi-home run game. Newton had a solo home run. We played really good. Crook had two RBIs. Hopefully the injury isn't bad, though. Pitching pitched really good. I mean, what are you going to do? We're trying to make some noise, make the playoffs, you feel me? So we get the injury report, and it's a broken arm that's going to end our boy Crook's season. I hate that. So now it's got to be left fielder by committee. We still got Dewey, second play left field. Probably going to have to have Patchy. Patchy Pache. As in game three, Seth Beer. Good God. Let's get it. Already got an early 1-0 lead. Beer. We have found our first baseman of the future. Line drive here in the second inning. We'll keep the scoring going as Zambrano makes this a 2-0 game. Top five, here's Nick Banks. Multi-home run game yesterday. And he gets a drive to left field. Is he going to have enough? over the wall for a home run. Banks, 3 home runs in his last 2 games. You love to see it. Bo Naylor, 7th inning. Yeah. Yeah. You knew that was gone. Let's go. 26 on the year. We might have a couple players get to 30. Dewey's ground ball. Out, but we drive in the runner, so it's 5-0. Here's Newton, and he takes ball 4 to walk in a run, so it's 6-0 here in the ninth. 2-2 count to Beer, and it's a base hit to the left fielder. That'll score 1. We got Pena on his way to. Okay, on his way home. I almost said on the way to third. Whitley looking to finish off a complete game shutout and gets him to strike out. So 8-0 shutout win. Forced Whitley. A complete game shutout. We had Puig on the roster. Whitley only gave up 1 hit, so he almost finished off a perfect game. It went into the 7th inning. He went into the 7th inning with a perfect game. I think he gave up a hit with 2 outs in the 6th. Yeah, it was 2 outs in the 7th, not 6th. Here we go. Last game of this 4-game series. So I'm sure they'd appreciate it. And why am I showing this? Well, the only reason you can notice why I'm showing this is because it's raining, and it's a rain delay. You love it. I swear they never give me a rain delay when I'm batting. It's only when I pitch. But after the rain delay, we got Abreu in the pitch, and the Tigers will take an early 1-0 lead here in the bottom of the third. Long 90-minute rain delay, so we're probably in trouble, aren't we? Gapper off the back of Scope again. They'll score 1 run. I doubt with 0 speed they're going to send him home. They do send him home. The throw to the plate. Not in time. 3-0 Detroit. So here's Naylor. Get over his head. Yes, sir. It does get over his head. That's going to score the runner from third easily. Runner from first will easily come around to score. And we got ourselves a 1-run ball game. So here we go, top 9. Banks got a little home run streak going, but he swings and misses at a changeup. Tying run with that third. Just couldn't get him home. Look at that. 3-2. So we end up splitting with the Tigers. 7 games total this year against the Tigers. I know we took 2 or 3 right before the All-Star break against them at home. So we went 4-3 against the Tigers. Definitely would have probably rather went like 5-2 or 6-1. Especially against a team like the Tigers who were nowhere close to competing. But we got to shake it off and head into this series against the White Sox. Quick little 3-game series on this road trip. Hey, Nick Banks is just on a different level, if you couldn't tell. Deep drive to right, left center field, and it's going to be over Jimenez's head, over the wall. Home run, Nick Banks. He's on a different level right now. Here's Jeremy Pena up. He hits one deep in the left center field. And look at Jeremy Pena. Jeremy, number 2 on the year for him, makes it 3-0. Here's Dewey's against Giolito. And that one's, is that going to be over the wall? No, it's just going to be off the wall, but that'll score the runner from first easily, and it's now a 4-0 lead, so we're attacking Giolito. They put Dylan Cease in the game. Oh, Bracho, deep drive off the bat of his, oh my God, is that over the wall? It is, look at that. Look at Bracho, 7 on the year for him. 6-0, here's Bracho again. And he hits it into the gap right there. We got the speedster Zambrano from first going all the way home. 7-0 lead. Here's Pena. And look at this. This is getting to the wall. That'll score Bracho. And Pena's got a double. It's 8-0 now. Here's Strope. Looking to finish off the team's complete game. And he does. So 8-0 win here against the White Sox. Big win that we needed right there. Big win, big win, big win. We definitely need to win games where we should be winning. We had Brinson in right, Dewey's in left. I mean, outfield is going to be a question the rest of the year with Crook being hurt. I hate that for him. He was in a really good year for us. Definitely going to let him get healthy and come back next year and have an impact. So he definitely hasn't lost his spot. That's easy. So here we go. Game two, Bo Meyer on the hill. And in the second inning, the White Sox will take an early 1-0 lead. Yasmani Grandal in the fourth inning, the lead off. Deep drive off the bat of his. And yeah, that's... Oh my God, I thought Deweese was going to catch it. Oh, just over his head. So it's 2-0. Here's Mankata. Pachi. Better throw for Pachi. Probably got him, but it's 3-0. Ninth inning. Ground ball. Is he going to be safe? Please beat this out. Thank you, Corey. Corey Lee beats it out. Oh, I was hoping Diaz off the bench pinch hitting. Flies out to the left fielder. And that ends the game 3-1. Now we got to play a rubber match in this three-game series against the White Sox. Going to go ahead and let you know. There's after the video part to this. So this is where my voice cuts out. See you guys. Alright guys, so you ready for this? I accidentally deleted the clip to this game. But we won 9-4, so I'll go over the box score real quick just for you guys before we get into this review of the month. As you see, Dewey, Beer, Lee each had multiple RBIs in this game. Beer and Lee with home runs for the White Sox. Garcia had a 3-run home run. And Basabe had a solo home run, so that was all their runs. Urquidy got hurt in the start. He had a shoulder injury. Abreu came in and pitched really good. And then the bullpen, 3 shutout innings, so you love to see that. Keuchel struggled. Cease did all right. And then Fulmer and Cordero shut down the door in the ninth inning. So we took the series against the White Sox 2-3. So now we're going to go ahead and get in this review of the month. And I told you guys going into August that August was going to have to be a big month for us, especially after the Minnesota series. And look at that. 1-0, 1-1, 2-1, 2-2, 3-2, 4-2, 5-2, 6-2, 6-3, 7-3, 8-3, 9-3, 10-3, 11-3, 12-3, 13-3. 13-3 at this point, then we lose 4 straight to go 13-7, 14-7, 15-7, 15-8, 16-8, 17-9, and 18-9. So we 18-9 in the month of August, so that was big after the Minnesota series. So yeah, that was big. Getting ready to take on Miami and Seattle. That'll be in the next video that you guys see. Looking at standings right here, we're currently 9 games out of first place. We're watching Oakland big time. We got to keep a track on the Angels. Mariners have been eliminated from all playoff play, so we ain't got to really worry about them. The Rangers, 7 games out of the wild, or 7 games out of the division, 15 out of the wild card. So wild card, we're a whole 1 game behind Tampa, so we're definitely going to be watching Tampa. Besides the Angels, I don't think we need to focus on the Red Sox. That's not who I'm planning on focusing on. But yeah, so let's go ahead and go through these. Let's start out with the awards. Still the same 3 in the awards race. Torres, Cole, and Brooke Diaz for MVP. Cole, Cy Young leading the way. Mancini even the batting title. Of course, we got the Rookie of the Year. Hank Aaron Award, Trout's leading that. Gold Glove for pitcher, Tolley's on here. I don't think anybody else is going to be on here for Gold Glove. Silver Slugger, though. Naylor's at catcher. Diaz at third. And that's it. Yep, that's it. So let's go ahead and look at players of the month. Diaz getting Rookie of the Month. 277 average, 8 home runs, 23 RBIs. Mancini hit 386. 9 home runs, 26 RBIs to win Player of the Month. And Severino, 4-0. This month gets him Pitcher of the Month. In the National League, we had Scherzer, and he just keeps winning it. That's the third time he's won it this year. Alonso hadn't won Player of the Month, so that's his first time. And then Harrison, for the second time this year, wins Rookie of the Month. Really good month for him. Injured list, to show you guys our injured list. Told you Urquidy got hurt in his last start. Might miss a start, don't know yet. Kirkpatrick's on sick. Like, look at all these players on the 60-day. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. We got 11 players alone on the 60-day, including our boy Crook. I'm sad that he's going to miss the rest of the season. He was playing really good. His season stats finished up with 18 home runs, 50 RBIs, 291 average. I mean, he was playing pretty good. I hate that his season came to an end. Top prospects list, we got, what, Pena, we got Blazovic, we got Davison Zeth, three of them now. I think that's it. Now Pache's down here. So we have four players on the top prospect list. We have made it to September, meaning we can expand our roster to two more call-ups, which I'm actually going to do right now. And I'm calling up bullpen arms because we need more bullpen arms. So Alex Reyes is getting the call-up. And then for the final one, I want to get another, like, position player that might help us out in the long run down the stretch. And really, I don't know who to call up. I feel like we probably need to have another outfielder on the roster. Puig is in the minor leagues, but I don't know about having him on the roster right now. But he's the only other outfielder that we have on the 40-man. So I'm probably going to just call up a middle infielder. And really, out of the middle infielders that, I mean, we can call it Garrett Stubbs and then Corey Lee. I mean, he can already play first, short, and then the outfield a little bit, so that could be an option. But I think in Logan Davison, I want to see what he's got for us, and we're going to call him up. He's going to be on the major league roster. Of course, he can't actually wear six because that's Newton's number. We're not going to make Newton change his number. So we're going to go ahead and change his number to, like, yeah, let's see, Logan Davison's going to wear number four because why not? And then we can get... Oh, whoops. We can get Newton back in number six. Just do that real quick. So, another bullpen arm, another middle infielder. Who knows, Logan Davison might be here to stay. We could have called Addison Russell up, but he's not really doing anything in AAA. But that gives us time to call up some of our hotter players in AA up to help them hopefully make the playoffs. I could have called up Gonzalez, I don't know. We will move up Owen Miller to AAA. And then, let's see, who else do I want to call up? We got how many outfielders? We got five of them already. Tyler Ward might end up getting called up too. Maybe, I don't know. Yeah, we'll call up another, like, infielder. Yeah, there's nobody actually that I'm really impressed with. So we'll just stick with 25 on both of those. Actually, we can call up a pitcher. Let's call up a pitcher, the AAA. Who's my highest ranked one? It's Earl Crane. So Crane's going back to AAA. And then we can put a single A player. I don't think we have that many single A players that aren't hurt. Yeah, we really actually don't have any single A players, so... Double A is already basically out of the playoffs, so no point on calling anybody up. But yeah, so of course we're looking at everybody else in our division. So the Angels are playing the Rangers right now and lost the first game. So the Rangers gotta play Angels and Oakland in this series. Of course, when we get to next week, next Monday, it's the last week or last day of the minor league season, so we'll play those games. Seattle getting ready to go to San Diego and then come to us. So you'll see that in the next video too. Oakland took game one against Kansas City. So they're trying to wrap up the division soon. They're playing Kansas City and Texas in this. And Angels, as you know, are playing the Rangers right now. And then they play Kansas City. So they got a long little homestand. Their next road trip is tough. They go to Cleveland, us, and Oakland. So it's getting rough for the Angels. We're also looking at Tampa Bay, because we're buying them in the wild card. They're playing Chicago right now. Then they go to Toronto. They still got to play the Yankees twice, so that helps us out a little bit. I know we still got to play the Yankees and the Yankees and Braves. Plus, we have to make we got to play the Angels. But this month is really a simple month for us. But I can't, like, overlook our opponents because, yeah. So we're gonna try to start this month off on the right note. A 3-game sweep of Miami. If we sweep this whole homestand, I'm gonna feel comfortable for real. Then we play the Angels here last time. Go to Texas, Angels, Baltimore. It's our last homestand. We definitely gotta sweep that. And then we go to New York, and I would like to split with New York, and then take 2 or 3 in Atlanta if we can, but who knows what's going to happen. So yeah, that's a quick little wrap up of the month. We're going to try to get through this month pretty quick. Like I said, the only minor league games that you will see are next week. Our minor league teams wrap up. Go look at their standings real quick. Well, you see it right here. As Round Rock is 1 game behind San Antonio, so they still have a shot to make the postseason. Hooks 24-34, 9 games out, they've been eliminated, so they're not going to make the playoffs, but we'll still get a chance to see. I don't know if we got our starters. So whoever starts the second game is going to be the starter we've seen that last game, so it's going to be Robert Duggar, and he has struggled. I got him in a trade thinking that he could help us out in the future, but not looking good right now. And then for it's going to be Jeff Bain that'll probably pitch that last game for us against San Antonio. Maybe. Yeah, because Mesoraco's off. And then he pitched. Yeah, see. Yeah. So, yeah, it's going to be probably Jeff Bain against San Antonio. And San Antonio is the last series of the year, which we got 4 games with them, and we're 1 game behind them. So, definitely got to look out for San Antonio. I'm not sure who San Antonio is with. Oh, they're with Milwaukee. They're playing Nashville and us. So, we got a shot to make the playoffs. Well, Triple A does. I know we definitely got a shot. We just got, I don't know about catching Oakland. Probably not going to catch Oakland, but as long as we can keep up with Tampa. And we won the season series against Tampa, so if we can maybe tie with them, I don't know if they're going to give us the tiebreaker or if we have to play a 1-game play-in for the 1-game wild card. We'll see, but yeah, next video you guys will see, we're taking on Miami and Seattle, so y'all be on the lookout for that. Sorry I didn't get the clip for that last White Sox game, accidentally deleted, so that's on my part. But yeah, I'll catch you guys on the next one. I can't breathe, I'm waiting.